Hi folks, it's Troy here. This is my Wenger Evolution S54. A few people have commented on it when they've seen it briefly in some other videos and have requested that I do a video on it so that you can have a bit of a closer look. I hope this is close enough. So we'll get into it. There's quite a bit to cover on here, and I thought the easiest thing to do would just be to pull the tools out and comment on them one by one. Wenger referred to this as one of their 85mm Swiss Army knives, referring to it from this point here to here, 85mm, which equates to 3 3/16 inches. The weight is 250 grams, which equates to 8.8 ounces. The main locking knife, stainless steel, came sharp out of the box and has retained a really good edge. It locks up and has a release bar at the front here. It is 65mm long, the knife blade itself, and which equates to 2 inches. We'll go up to this end and we'll get straight into it. There is a can opener. Haven't used that, but I believe it would be really effective. I've used can openers like it before, and I can just tell that that'll do the job. Slightly different to the Victorinox one. They differ slightly, but I believe that would work. There is a flat blade screwdriver, which I have used up here, and also a can opener. They're going to do what they're going to do. They're, the flat blade is quite effective. There is a ruler and a compass. Now, the compass works well. It's quite small, but it does work. And the ruler, although it you wouldn't think that it could be too wrong, I don't like. The ruler I find hard to use because it's a big, thick bar. I don't like that the compass is in the way of my when I want to measure smaller things up here, and I don't like the shape of it. I would much prefer to see this as a really flat end up here. And I reckon they could have put the ruler on one of these other tools further down, or even put a ruler on the outside. I just don't like that plastic ruler. But it's there, it does work. It's just a bit of a pain, really. And the compass works. It's a dry compass, but it's quite effective, and I found it to be accurate. Next tool along is the file and metal saw. Now, the file edges are pretty self-explanatory, and then there's also a file edge there, which acts as a hacksaw blade for cutting metal and hard plastics. I've used it for both, and it works fantastically. Next tool along is the wood saw and plastic saw. I've used it for cutting soft plastic. I haven't used it for cutting wood. Again, it worked quite effectively. Deploys relatively easily. Next tool along is the magnifying glass and jeweler's screwdriver. I think that's too big on the end here to be called a jeweler's screwdriver, but they call it a jeweler's screwdriver. And the magnifying glass is pretty self-explanatory and works quite effectively. And I think that's a really good addition to have. I think that's a real gem, that one. Next tool along, and I reckon this is where they could put the ruler. They could modify this tool a bit and put a ruler on here. This is their fish scaler, fish degorger, and line guide. Now, I haven't used this for scaling fish. I can't imagine using this tool on scaling fish. It's going to get quite messy, but with all these openings here, but you could do it if you needed to. You could also use the back of your knife, so I'm not really sure why they put that in. And the line guide and fish degorger, well, I haven't used either one of those yet, but they're there if you need them. And I reckon that looks handy for punching through an item, putting a piece of rope through there, and then pulling back for doing some like stitching if you had to. That's what I envisioned using that for if I needed to. Next tool along are our scissors. Some of these tools are harder to deploy than others. I found the scissors, they're a little bit finicky. They're there. Actually, I haven't liked these scissors. I've used them on a couple of occasions and haven't found them to cut as well as I would have liked them to. But they're there. Might be better if they worked a little bit better. I do have some bugbears about those. The next two tools along are probably the hardest two tools to get out. First one is the all-purpose wrench. Really, really stiff. And if your fingernail's too long, it just bends before you can get it out. That's the all-purpose wrench. I think that opening's about 7mm, or let me just have a quick look here, about somewhere between 2/8 of an inch and 3/8 of an inch. It's quite small, but I have used it and it did work when I needed it to do a little job that I wanted to tighten up. So it's handy to have, I guess. It works effectively. It's just limited in its range. The other next tool along, opposite to the wrench, is the Phillips head screwdriver. Found that it's a Phillips head screwdriver. It does what it needs to do. It is probably a little bit stubby than what you might require sometimes, but that's the price that you pay for these things. They're compact. Can't say too much more about it. Next one along is the wrench. These are sliding jaw wrenches, so they adjust their size. As you can see there, that's a little bit more open. And then you give it a little jiggle and it can close right up. And yeah, the pliers, they do work. They don't grab anywhere near as good as my Leatherman. But again, this tool is different to my Leatherman. We've already touched on the knife. Up this end here as well, we have our nail file and our nail cleaner. These both work how you'd expect them to, although with my big fat nails, I tend to use the other file a fair bit. On the opposite side, there's the corkscrew. Haven't used it, but it looks effective. Now, these different tools have different strengths of metal. I believe things like the corkscrew are the really hard types of metal, whereas your knife, they use slightly different stainless so that you can put an edge on it. But trying to find information on that was quite hard. Also on this side, we have an awl, which is brilliant. I have used this quite a few times. It's really good for punching holes and things. I would not have a multi-tool if it didn't have an awl on it or some way that I could make a hole decently. I think an awl is really important. I actually prefer the awls that have a little hole in here so that you can use them for stitching. But like we talked about before, we have the fish degorger that has the line guide on it, and we could use that. We could use that for doing stitching with if we needed to. There's a key ring or lanyard holster. As you can see, I do use that. Now, the reason I have that on here is because on my Maxpedition Fat Boy, which is similar to a similar type pouch to on my Triad Admin pouch here, this being such a short tool, it goes in there so deeply that it's really quite difficult to get out. So I have the lanyard on there so that when I want get it out quickly, bang, it's out. And yeah, what more can I say? It works. What else can we talk about just briefly about this tool? They do it in an Evo grip, which means that it's the same similar red, but this is has like a textured rubber type feel to it, inlaid into the plastic. They call that the Evo grip. This is the Evolution. So, I think that's about it. Oh, there is two more tools. There is the tweezers. I have used those for slithers and splinters and various things. And there's the toothpick, which I have also used. I apologise for my hand being in the way, but this is quite hard to do because it's such a small tool. Have used that toothpick as well. 18 tools. Should have checked them off as we did it, but I think we might have covered them all. If I've left one out, let me know. See you guys.